There must be a guy like me in every town on Earth. A jaded, broken man, unshackled by the burdens of moral society. The guy you go to when you don't want to dirty your hands or find out the awful little secrets you probably weren't meant to know. You'd think a job like this would pay more than it does. Still, the bourbon helps. Yeah, Roxy.
Mr. Stone.
Roxy.
Mr. Stone.
Yeah, Roxy.
Ah, to hell with this.
For crying out loud, Jimmy. Don't you get this damn thing fixed already?
Yeah. What do you want anyway?
There's a client here to see you, Mr. Stone.
I'm really not in the mood right now, Roxy.
Don't worry, Jimmy. This one will put you in the mood. She's a total fox.
No kidding. Well, by all means, show her in.
Mr. Stone, my name is Amelia Drysdale. I believe I have need of your services.
Well, I can't imagine what else. Bring a dame like you out here on such a lousy night. Why don't you have a seat and tell me exactly what's on your mind?
Thank you. Cold night out there, Mr. Stone. Aren't you gonna offer me that bourbon you have in your desk?
I'm afraid. Only have one glass. Just a little dirty.
That's all right. I don't mind a little dirty.
I was starting to get that impression. I'd seen her type before, though they were rarely so easy on the eyes. A high-class dame who hadn't started out that way. So what can I do for you, Miss Drysdale?
I won't beat around the bush, Mr. Stone. I'm the mistress of a very wealthy and powerful man. Certain promises were made to me by this man, and I intend to see that he keeps them.
Go on.
The problem is his wife, a cruel and spiteful woman. While he insists he'll leave her, I simply wish to ensure he has the courage to carry out his intentions.
So you want me to keep tabs on your rich meal ticket to make sure he's not cheating with his wife? Isn't that a little bit backwards?
I'm not sure you understand what's at stake here, Mr. Stone. My lover is none other than Warren Wainwright II.
That kid that inherited Soltech? My hat's off to you, Miss Drysdale. That's the brass ring of mule tickets.
I can tell you that Soltech's current endeavors will launch them beyond the realm of aeronautics and communications. They will become a leading force in the corp sector. A Goliath in a world in which I intend to secure my future. These new developments are in no small part due to Warren's efforts. He's a visionary, Mr. Stone, and very much a man.
I'm sure. We're talking about a serious surveillance job here. Someone with that kind of dough is going to have a lot of safety and security precautions. This ain't going to be easy or cheap.
I assume 1,000 per day will suffice. Plus expenses, of course. I'll expect full written reports twice weekly with as close to round-the-clock surveillance as you can manage. I'm not interested in taking any chances. You want to clean yourself up as well. Warren and his shrew are hosting a party tomorrow night at their Waverly estate. It'll be a casual affair, and I've taken the liberty of adding a contractor by the name of Cameron Miller to the guest list.
And I'm assuming no one's ever seen this Cameron guy?
If you manage to find yourself a respectable date, this might provide you with an opportunity to get an idea of the kind of security Warren surrounds himself with.
Now hang on, sweetheart. I haven't even said I'd take this case.
But of course you will. Money talks. Bourbon isn't cheap.
She's right. No way in the world am I going to pass on this kind of paycheck. Still, I'm not so stupid as to walk blindly into a job that pays more than twice its worth either. The dame wasn't telling me the whole story, but they never did. I'd have to be careful. Well, more careful than usual. Neil's the kind of cop who knows how to stay just enough on the take to avoid being dirty and cut few enough corners to still kid himself he's fighting the good fight. Despite the slight shred of decency, Neil's still a good friend from the old days. An alright guy to have in a tight spot.
Detective Johansson?
Neil, it's Stone.
Jimmy, what's the word?
Just picked up a new client.
Skirt?
With teeth.
Is there any other kind?
I guess not.
Name?
Amelia Drysdale.
Legs?
Two.
Hair?
Blonde.
Eyes?
Can't stop thinking about them. Look, I need you to check her out. She might be clean, but...
probably isn't. I'll give her a once-over and let you know.
Cheers. I tried to decide if I just arranged to a background check on my new client, or pimped her out to a cop. Sometimes talking all cool could get a little confusing. Hey, Roxy.
Yeah, Jimmy?
What are you doing tomorrow night?